We're rolling.
We are not
we're
only
recording
rolling,
this?
we're running actually.
We're really doing this?
Yeah, well.
I mean, it's super weird because like I can read your body language and I can see like your face and stuff and like it's just so strange this world that we're living in right now where like you're seeing like a mask and sunglasses.
I know. And the last time we did this, we were practically the last time we did this, we had a massive problem with the phone.
Yeah.
We had a delamination that should not have happened, which is totally...
I like your scientific delamination, where I gave you a phone so cheap that just peeling the plastic, you ripped the back of the phone off.
By removing the plastic.
By removing the plastic.
So, and surprisingly enough, though, that company did reach out to me a couple times asking me if I wanted to review their other phones. I'm like, no, I'm
okay. Good.
Based on the last experience, I'm pretty sure.
I think we're going to be doing much better.
I hope.
For this
hope.
Challenge.
Yeah.
But we're also climbing way up the price premium.
We went from like 35 to like 1,000.
To more. It's more.
Yeah, well like 1,300, which
it's more.
Reasonable stuff.
Try not to throw your mic on the ground.
If you don't mind.
I definitely won't do that. So I put together a kit. I mean, you showed up with a phone in a box
and
a case, so that's helped. But I put together...
Well, mine is all inclusive.
An experience because we're talking productivity.
Well, we are talking productivity. And so the main thing I wanted to make sure I felt like
here,
comparison.
I'm going to do the exchange. I'm going to slide over.
I'll put mine here.
It was very convenient of Lake Balboa to put these benches out that are roughly 6-7 feet long for us to exchange.
And it is open air, so we're making sure. So, and I really like the case, by the way. It's actually a really nice organization.
It came from a battery, but it was sort of perfect because
it
I wanted you
a nice little hook.
I wanted you to have the whole experience. What I was talking about on my live stream is it's not just, you know, like a phone and you kind of poke at it with your finger. It's like you can do a whole thing with it. So
and my hope is to try that out. So the thing about it is, as you guys probably already aware of, we're trying to do another phone challenge. We did it last time and I think it was a great experience.
This is three.
I was gonna say this is not number two, number three. The first one we did was truly a comparison where we exchanged phones.
Woo!
And then now we
beautiful.
Have this epic, you know.
So I mean, I think camera was one of our first focuses.
As it should
be. Going LG, I think better video versus Huawei with much better stills.
The P series is known for their cameras.
Absolutely.
I think that's why we did that.
And phone challenge two was how cheap can we go and maintain a usable phone, and I absolutely lost. But I would say
you won because you went for the cheapest. I mean, if you think about it.
I got the good phone, so I won the challenge in receiving, but I lost the challenge in giving. But this one I was really excited because I think this is also going to be sort of a slightly different take.
Yeah.
It's not just phone to phone.
No.
Because we also want to mix in some other devices.
The V60 I feel like is that wild card. So we both have the V60 and both of us have used it for some time. So the beautiful part about it is the V60 offers that nice little, I would say, that kind of a wild card or almost like a jack of all trades.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can use it as a phone, you can use it with a dual screen, and you can use it with a pen if you want. And if you don't, you could just use it as a regular phone.
Right.
So I feel like that'll be our wild card that we can kind of use as a measuring
stick. So I'm getting the stylus phone.
I was going to say, you're getting the tried and true, proven system that Samsung has been putting out for, I would say, a gazillion years.
Mm-hmm.
Which essentially is the Note 20 Ultra. So we're doing the Note 20 Ultra, and if you guys probably already saw the videos on this, there's a whole bunch of things on our side, on my channel. And then for me is, coincidentally, the other productivity king that just literally came out.
Mm-hmm.
And just for reference, I did show up some videos earlier, and that was a device that wasn't mine. Unfortunately, I couldn't spend that much time. So truly, this is my time of using it as an actual productivity device. That's why you haven't seen a lot of other devices, videos from me. But it's the Surface Duo. It's a all-the-time dual-display productivity device that supports, and I do appreciate basically Juan Carlos including this with, because I needed to actually borrow my wife's, an actual pen that you can use. Mm-hmm. So this is a Surface pen. I think this is the first generation?
It's the Surface Slim.
Surface Slim.
So it's the first generation Surface Slim pen. But in trying to find dual display, it's really hard to find cases and stuff for it. I love magnets. You gotta love magnets.
You gotta love the fact that
I put together like a carry case for you because I really do believe that this is an Android tablet that can help you keep a laptop at home. less a phone. But because of that, if you dig into the kit that I put together, I also included it's good. You're not going to be impressed by that.
If you haven't
at
seen
all.
The video on the adapter on Juan Carlos,
it's proper
channel,
bad.
Check it out.
but the bumpers. If you want to put the bumpers on, but this was the biggie for me was including the little folding Bluetooth keyboard from Microsoft.
The OG Microsoft keyboard.
So this, I mean, that came out during the days of Continuum. But if you hold up the Surface next to it, I mean, it's almost like it was designed.
They're about the same size
to be
actually,
used
if you think about it. Yeah.
Together. It's so beautiful how well they carry.
And I'll show you guys some close-ups right now with this, obviously. They open up very nicely. The Surface has a lot of functionalities, which I really like about it. But you can definitely see, you know, usability very, very nice. So I
think this is going to be a fun challenge because with the Note, I'm really looking forward to playing with, you know, a beast multimedia device that also, I think, still sets a standard for desktop-style productivity.
Absolutely.
Dex
had a massive upgrade when this version of One UI came out. So, and some of the other devices have already received it. The short answer is, I feel like he's getting a great productivity device, and he's sharing with me his productivity device. And we're going to go for 2 weeks. It's pretty much the same thing.
We go 2 weeks.
We'll do a couple of videos back and forth as far as the experience. And as I mentioned, we're going to be using the V60 as our kind of like a measurement system. How does it compare to a wildcard? Is it truly as versatile? Is it truly a productivity device?
Yeah.
Because for me, my needs are probably going to be a little bit different than what you
totally.
Need. And that's, I think, where the challenge happens. So keep it here. Make sure you check out both of our side. We're going to be going back and forth, and hopefully not too much bad-mouthing stuff. But
lots of smack talking.
A lot of that actually will come out.
I'm winning this one. I put together a beautiful representation of mobile productivity.
I agree.
But I got to say, I mean, for all of this going down, I mean, your wardrobe is totally on point. I mean, that's maybe the coolest
I show up to the show with straight out just like supporting the channel.
I need to get your merch. I need your beard logo on like posters.
We'll work it. I think for the final part of the video when we do the trade back, I think maybe we'll... I hope I have something by that point.
Yeah, I mean, let me know. I think it's a darn shame.
I know.
I can't get like keychains and like beer cozies
I'm in the process of talking to the same guys over the same lady actually that worked with Matt and Sam from Across the Pond.
Perfect.
So those are the
people you'll get some quality stuff.
But I do have to say before we leave the video, just not that too much of a jab. You did have to put a lot of accessories to make this device.
I didn't have to.
I know.
I was being considerate to deliver what the Surface experience might resemble. This is the philosophy. Because you've already gotten to play with it. It's not like this is going to be a huge surprise.
I played with it at Best Buy. I played with it at the office a few times. I got a chance to check out desktop experience, a whole bunch of things. It definitely changes the way you think of using the device, which I really appreciate.
And as soon as I present it to other people saying, this is one of the best tablets I've ever used, and it kind of approximates an okay phone.
Yeah.
That to me becomes one of the most exciting aspects of this conversation.
I think that's breaking this down.
The Note, I think still would by many be an easy win for what peak slab of smartphone resembles.
Yeah.
LG strategy is way more modular.
It is.
But now Microsoft is doing something not safe. I mean,
they're going very much on the limb, and especially with the announcement of what's happening with the other Surface. Supposedly that one's going on hold. So it looks like this is pretty much where they're betting all of their eggs are in one basket right now.
their mobility basket is Android, which is hilarious.
But it is the only device you could do this. And truly enjoy it.
And I mean, I know you've got the Fold, but you can keep going.
Oh yeah, no. Yeah. It is not by any means a stops from one position to the other.
Just it's so pretty. And
literally.
And I love, like, because, you know, I didn't get to spend much time with the S20, that it really does seem to be about the same thickness as the camera bulge.
The other problem, but the other thing that is different here also is the new camera system with the massive hump, which is a... Very similar to the S20 line, if you really look and enjoy massive camera humps.
But that is a domino.
It is. And that's why I included the... Oh, I didn't... Okay, so I'll have to send them a case in the mail. I thought I included a case.
Oh, no. The case is back at the car.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, no.
We got a case. I mean, I was going to make fun of you because I did all this.
Yeah.
And you know, it's the box. That's kind of neat.
So,
but.
Keep it tuned. Let me know what you guys think, especially what would you like me to compare. Obviously, the main goal is the Duo versus the Note 20 Ultra, and of course the V60 as the wild card on both ends. Mm-hmm. Because again, both of us have the device and it's easy for us to basically compare our experience with it. Make sure you check out both our channels. Juan Carlos's information will be obviously in the description below. Like and subscribe as usual, and let me know, what do you want me to focus on with, well, my devices obviously, so the V60 and the Duo. And of course, we'll see you guys in the next video.